Group E semifinal two, you can see there. We got Pastrana, Backerud. We're seeing, who's that?
Erickson and Erickson.
Deegan.
And Deegan as well.
Yep. All right.
So on the front row, the two drivers who got penalized yesterday in the final for over-aggressive driving. How aggressive are they going to be on the run to the first corner? Pastrana versus Backerud. Good start by Ole Erickson on row two. Backerud, though, has got the best of them. Is he going to go long here? Pastrana tends to jump long into the first corner. He does go deep. Now, look, Backerud puts some rotation on. Deegan trying to get the inside. Ole Erickson keeps it super low. And Backerud and Pastrana get into each other on the exit. Who's got it as they go over the gap? Jumping is Pastrana in the lead of Backerud right in his bumper. Deegan trying to go up high.
Barely, though. Again, this is where I think Backerud, watch him. He's going to tiptoe. He knows he has something kind of not to prove because, again, everybody's aggressive. Oh, boy. And there we go. We're talking jokers. We're talking non-jokers.
That's that place, Jared, where the grip level is really crucial. You want to get good exit speed through there, but it's narrow, so you get too much rotation on the car. We've seen people bouncing it out of the banks before. So Pastrana went joke. You can see him here. Ole Erickson went as well. Backerud from P2 chose to go on the standard lap. We'll have to see what the gap is. We think the delta's changed from around 11 to 9. And, again, that's due to the track condition changing on each run.
Yeah, and even the previous semifinal to this, it's going to absolutely alternate. So
Kevin Erickson is piling the pressure onto Deegan. Erickson, the championship leader, gets alongside Brian Deegan. Contact over the jump. Very brave from both these two. They come over the start-finish line. Erickson gets into Deegan again. Deegan sideways, gets on the lock stop, somehow holds on. The ex-metal pressure, man.
Awesome. Flirting with that gap jump. Again, Erickson was right there. He saw a little nudge. Deegan not scared at all. You got to think, you know, Deegan's raced trucks here on this course before. Not the same layout, but, from two wheels to four wheels, from trucks to side-by-sides, he's done it all.
He's loving it. I was up with his team earlier on. He's absolutely loving it. Yeah. He said, he's coming this morning. He said, I'm loving it. He said, I'm going to be in Glen Helen anyway. If there's a spare car, I want to race. He's coming there for this. Side-by-side stuff. So, come on, I want to see Deegan in the car more. I think it's a really impressive debut. He's up against very, very strong drivers who've been in the car a lot more. It's not an easy thing to just jump into.
Hey, and Coley, real quick.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, you see those red X's. That denotes that those drivers have hit the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. We're bigging up Deegan here. Yeah, he's in the last place. But what is a Joker lap? Just break it down real quick for those who just tuned in.
Basically, if you've never watched any of this kind of sport before, nitrocross, rallycross, they have a Joker lap. It's our tactical advantage. Look at Formula One. When do you take your pit stop to try and get track position? And this is the same. So you take your Joker lap. On this occasion, it's short. Sometimes it's longer. And you pick a point when you think you're going to get out of traffic, give yourself some clear air to push, and try and close that gap down. At the minute, though, Backerud not doing a quick enough job. 11.7 back. And Pastrana should hold on.
All right. So, again, it's just one driver advancing on. We saw Pastrana get the fast pass in the finals. He joined us here in the booth. Maybe we'll get Larson in here. I'd love to get Larson in the booth and rap out about his, what's going on with him.
He was good last night, wasn't he? Larson was measured, where I think some other people were. He had every right to be super disappointed. Yeah. He had pushed a tire off the rim, unlucky. But he was like, you know what, championship, it's gone my way. Kevin's lost points, I've gained points. He's now only 9 points off that championship leader, and he's on the front row already. Yeah. So it's a great job by him.
All signs are saying that it's going to be Pastrana. You can see that 11.3 split between Backerud and Pastrana. We're talking about that delta, and there it goes. I believe that was Backerud probably jumping over him.
3/10 Backerud took on the last one, Jared, but it's not enough because the gap's 11.5 and it needs to be more like 9.5. So he was going quicker than Travis, but by now Travis's spotter will probably be on the radio going, look, you got this, dude, just keep it tight.
You're on your right now.
Here we go. Okay. There's Backerud on the right. Backerud's going to re-enter the picture here. He could get into a tussle with Holly Erickson.
Guard your left
there
side.
There we go.
Guard your left side.
In, and there he is. He just gave way. That was a smart thing to do. Your fight for number two position, which has no repercussions. So Travis Pastrana will advance on to the finals. He grabs the checkered flag. And Pastrana, 199, is in it alongside Larson.
Same front row as yesterday.
Yep.
Power Plus vehicle is on fire. Nitro Cross straight to the final. Let's go.
It's almost like he knows we're on him, isn't it? What a pro.
Says the car's on fire, straight to the final. Let's go. That's right. How we doing out there, Arizona and around the world? We are live. Make some noise for all of our drivers as Pastrana gets the win and advances on to the finals. Erickson, Backerud, the other Kevin Erickson, and Brian Deegan are headed to the LCQ.
So take a look at the start. Backroot gets a really good start, and over this first crest, I'm not going to see it, he was good, but Pastrana went deeper off it, up in turn one then, everybody stayed out the wall, and Travis managed to get the whole shot. Kevin Erickson looked, sticking wheels out. Ah, Kevin got too hooked up, that's what we saw Conor Martel do. If you put your wheel too far over the inside, the bank will suck you into the corner.
That was great,
this
man.
This was incredible.
I think Kevin said, hey, welcome. You know, like Kevin said, hey, welcome in, Brian, but I'm going to show you little things. And Brian didn't flinch. It's like that bully goes and tries to fake punch at you. Brian didn't flinch.
Super, super brave for both of them as well. But they knew what was going on. There was a little bit of contact over the crest. They kept their wheels straight. That's what they had to do to stay out of trouble. Travis gave them all a big briefing yesterday, going, if you're coming over this jump together, it's up to you to make sure that neither of you takes the other one off.
Yeah.
Respect between them.
So much fun. All right. So, again, two drivers are already in. Same front row as we saw yesterday. Pastrana and Larson on the front row. Man, what a great track and what great fans. Thanks for joining us here at Nitrocross here in Arizona.